theoretical topics of first module I had completed. Okay, so only the rest part is to solve the numerical. So yesterday I told you that I will tell you to how to solve that numerical that you are posting in the WhatsApp group. Okay, so wait, let me find that. Okay, and regarding the RL circuit and RC series, the RC circuit transient analysis, is there any query?
Okay.
Okay, because that portion was totally completed and 1.6, I think. Just a minute. Okay, just a minute. Okay, we were talking about this numerical. Okay, just a minute, the screen. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So some of you already solved that. Okay, and some of you were doing some were wrong. So according to the superposition theorem, what is the concept? We are going to use the source one at a time. Okay, so there are three number of sources, voltage sources. Okay, and look, it is told that the link that has to be connected between the terminals AB, that means one link is connected here and no resistance is there. So that means this path is short circuited. Is that okay to everyone? Okay, so when I am considering the 50 volt source, first I am considering this 50 volt source. Okay, so how the circuit will be? The circuit will look like, this is our source, this is our 10 ohm, this is our shorted path, and then this one, again this is shorted 10 ohm, 2 ohm, okay, and this voltage source will also be shorted. Okay, so now look, this is your 3 ohm, this is your 10 ohm, and this one is your 2 ohm. So yes, you can say that total 15 ohm is connected in parallel. Okay, because 3, 10 and 2 ohm are in series. So I can say that one 15 ohm resistance is in parallel with 0 ohm resistance. Now, if you can remember correctly, if there is a shorted path in parallel with another resistance, then maximum amount of current, or rather you can say all the current that will flow through that shorted path. Okay, so no current will flow through this 15 ohm, correct? So through this link AB, how much current will flow? That is simply 50 by 10. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Okay, very good. Now do this for this 10 volt source and 20 volt source. Okay, now if I am considering the 10 volt source, what will be your circuit? The circuit will look like this. This is your 50 volt shorted. Okay, now we are considering the 10 volt. Remember, here 50 volt has been considered, here 10 volt I am considering. So This is another shorted path. This shorted path, that is AB. Okay. Look, if this kind of namings are already there in the circuit, so to show the current direction, always use the notations. That means the current flowing, the magnitude is 10 ampere or 5 ampere, and direction is A to B. Okay, or B to A. So that will help you to understand the direction of current flow. Right. So here it will be 3 ohm. Now 10. Okay. This is your 10 volt. Again, this one is shorted. Then 2 ohm. Okay. So look, again, maximum current, the current flow direction will be in this side. Okay, the current direction will be like this, because look, this is your shorted path, okay, and this is your resistive path. So maximum current will flow through this shorted path. So through this 10 ohm path, no current will flow. Correct. So how much is the magnitude of your current? That is 10 volt. Okay. Divided by, look, all the resistances are in series. Correct. So 3 ohm, 2 ohm, 10 ohm, total 15 ohm. So that means we can say this value is 2/3 ampere, and the direction is, I will write this as
downward, sir.
Downward, not downward, from A to B. If you if you take the mirror image of the circuit, the current direction will remain same, but the downward direction will be upward. Okay, so don't call like the current direction is downward or current direction is sidewise. Always tell that current magnitude is this, and the direction is from either A to B or B to A. Correct. Either X to Y or Y to X. That will help you to remember the direction. Right. Now, in next case, third, we are talking about that 20 volt source. Okay. So what will be your circuit? Your circuit will look like this is 10. 5. This is your shorted path. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Now, look, this 10 volt is also again, okay, this 20, this is your 50 volt. So this 50 volt will be shorted exactly. So this 50 volt will be shorted. Here 10 volt will be shorted. This 10 ohm is present here. This is your negative. This is your positive, this is your 2 ohm. Okay, so this is your 10, this is your 2. Now, what is your current direction from positive? The current will flow like this. Okay, this will be your direction. And since this is your shorted path, so no current will flow through this. All the current will go through this shorted path. Okay, this is your current direction. So look, the current direction is again from A to B, right? So what is your current magnitude? It is 20/15. So you can say this value is almost 4/3, right? And direction is A to B. Here, what is your direction? This 5 ampere, A to B. Clear. So now what is your total current flow through that link, the total current flow will be added. Why? Because look, all the currents are flowing in the same direction. Okay, do not say it is upward or downward or sidewise or leftwise, rightwise. No, the current direction will be from this point to that point. That means from X to Y or M to N or A to B or B to A. So likewise, you have to notify that what is your current magnitude and what is your current's direction. So what is your total current? I am writing this IT equals to 5 ampere plus 2/3 plus 4/3. Okay, is that okay? Look, everyone, is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
So total current flowing is 7 ampere. Okay, now where it is wrong? In the solution that I sent you in the PDF, if you look, I deliberately did this minus instead of plus, but none of you pointed me out. Only one student pointed me out that. Okay, so whenever you are trying to calculate the current, always look in what direction that current is flowing. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, this numerical already I had shown you. Now, next is this numerical. Okay. Now, how to solve this kind of numerical? Look, the steady state is reached in the circuit shown in the below figure when the switch is at 1. At t equals to 0, the switch is moved. This will be 2, position 2. Okay. And find the drop across the capacitor as well as the resistor, and also find the energy stored across the capacitor after t equals to 0.1 millisecond. That means, look, the switch is moved from zero, from this, the at t equals to zero, the switch is moved from 1 to 2. So before t equals to zero, the state was already in steady state condition, the circuit was already in steady state condition. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So what was your circuit before t equals to zero? Your circuit will be, the circuit was, your circuit was, this is your connection, 50 ohm. And at steady state, yesterday I told you that when the capacitor gets fully charged, then it won't take any amount of current. So at that time, the capacitor will act as one open circuit, right, at the steady state condition. Do you remember this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is the meaning of this open circuit? That means the capacitor is fully charged. And what is the voltage across that capacitor at that moment? Can you tell me? This is your 10 volt, okay? This is your 50 ohm. And here is your capacitor at open circuit condition. Okay, so what is the voltage during that open circuit? The voltage will be same as this, source voltage. Okay, because look here, just a minute, let me show you. Look here at this point, I already discussed that at t equals to zero and at t equals to infinite. What is the meaning of t equals to infinite? The system is in steady state. So when the system is in steady state, the VC will be equal to the VS, the source voltage. Okay, that means here the system is already in steady state condition. It is connected to 1. Okay, the system was already in steady state condition. So at that time, I can say that Vc is 10 volt. Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so now what we are going to do, we are going to check the potential very carefully. What is the potential of the capacitor and what is the polarity? So the potential value, already you know the magnitude, and what is the polarity? Polarity at that time, this will be positive, this will be negative. Okay, because same polarity it will have. Okay, because this circuit is fully open, right? Because Vc is fully charged. So that's why the same polarity will appear here. Correct. Now, this switch moved to second position. Now, what is happening here? Now, we are again going to draw the circuit. Look, this is connected at second position. And here, the voltage is in opposite direction. Look here. Okay, it is in opposite direction. So our drawing is little bit wrong. We are going to correct it. Okay, so this is our voltage now, and this is our new circuit. This is your 5 volt, but look, the polarity is negative, positive. Okay, and this value is 0.1 microfarad. Okay, now what we are going to do? We are going to calculate the voltage using the KVL law. Okay, so what is, according to KVL law, what we can write? Suppose the current is flowing like this. Okay, you can say the current is flowing like this. It's up to you, whatever direction you want to choose. But I am choosing that the current flow is like this. So as the current flow is like this, so what I can say? I am moving from positive to negative, that means voltage drop. So I am writing minus 5. Clear? Again, voltage drop across the 50 ohm. So minus 50 I. Again, capacitor is one type of passive element. So minus of, what should I write? 1 by C integration I dt equals to 0. Is the equation correct?
Yes, sir.
Any no problem here? Okay. Now, what is the meaning of I in place of, just like the previous, minus 50? What is the meaning of I? C dVc dt. Okay. Minus, what I can write here? Vc equals to 0. Correct. Now, from here, I can write that 50 C dVc dt, keep that in one side, equals to minus of Vc plus 5. Is that right? Is this right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now from here, your work is to calculate the Vc. Okay, one kind of equation you will get. Okay, I am not doing that. That's your work. Okay, who is joining now? No, sorry. Okay. Now, so from here, you will get one VC equation and one K value you will get. Okay. One K value you will get, that is a constant, integration constant. Okay. Now, here, put the initial condition. What is your initial condition? Your initial condition is at t equals to 0. What is your capacitor voltage? At t equals to 0, what is your capacitor voltage?
10 volt.
Very good. So VC is your 10 volt. Okay. So use that condition and calculate the value of VC. Okay. So if you have found out the value of VC at, and this VC you are getting with respect to T, and at that point this T value is already given here. Okay. And what is told here? Find the drop across the capacitor. So this VC is your drop across the capacitor. Correct. So if you calculate the VC at T equals to 0.1 millisecond, then you can find out the VC value very easily. Clear? Now, what is told here? Again, find out the energy stored. So what is the energy? That is V into I, that you already know. Correct. So I am writing above. Look, but I don't have place here. So I know that V equals to V into I. Okay. So here, what is the value of I? You have already calculated C into dV dt. Correct. V into C into dV dt. That is the value of I. Okay, so from here you can calculate, you, if you calculate the total energy, this is nothing but the power loss. So P into dt is your energy. Correct. Power into time will give you the energy value. So energy value will be half into CV square. Right, because V into dV you are getting here. So if you integrate, half CV square you will get. Correct. So this is your formula. Now it's up to you. Okay, whatever value you are getting, post that in WhatsApp. It's your homework today. Okay. Now, today we are going to solve some numericals. Okay. Okay, fine. So your first numerical will be, just a minute, let me share the screen. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, okay, very good. So now your first numerical today that we are going to practice. Okay, see, basic electrical engineering is fully based on practice. If you don't practice, you will forget whatever you learned. Okay, so practice every day, minimum two numerical or one numerical, so that you can recapitulate what you had learned from the class. Okay, and already I am sending all the documents in classroom. Okay, and 1.8 module, that PPT number 1.8, I hadn't sent. Okay, today I will upload that. So your today's numerical is, okay, I hope all of you have copy right now. So draw this numerical. Yeah, Okay, so this is your load point A, this is your B, okay. This is one current source connected here, value is 2 ampere, okay. This is your 10 ohm resistance, this is your 10 volt source, check the connection. Okay, this is your 5 ohm, this is your 1 ohm. Okay, so now your work is to find out the current flow through this 1 ohm, I1 equals to what, using the superposition theorem. Okay, so I am giving you 2 minutes. Some of you take this 2 ampere and some other students take 10 volt source. Okay, now tell me, you have 2 minutes time, take that time and solve this right now. Okay. Okay, is there any progress? Hello, is there any progress? Have you tried?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, you are trying? Okay. So, without wasting any time, I am doing it. Now, check your process. Okay, so first I am considering this 2 ampere. Okay, everyone please mute yourself. Okay, so I am considering first the 2 ampere. Okay, and some of you are considering their 10 volt source. Okay, 10 volt source, and I and this is 2 ampere source. Okay, so when I am considering this 2 ampere source, how will be your circuit? Your circuit will look like this. This is your shorted path, correct? Because voltage source will be shorted, current source will be opened. Okay, this is your 5, this is your 1. Okay, this is your 1. This is your 5 and this is your 10, correct? And this is your 2 ampere. So, what process should I take? Should I choose? Anyone?
KVL sir.
KVL is a law.
Nodal analysis.
Sir, nodal analysis.
Nodal analysis. Nodal analysis. Yes, nodal analysis. Okay. See, there are two kinds of analysis: nodal analysis, mesh analysis.
And sir, by mesh we can also do sir.
Yes, you can do it, but it will take time. Look, here, if you take the node, only one variable V will be there. But if you are considering nodal analysis, the mesh analysis, one current here, another current here, okay, another current here. So total three variables are there. So if you can control the three variables, so you can do that. I have no objection. It's up to you. Okay. Now, look, I am not considering the mesh analysis because it will take much time for this type of problem. Okay. So I am doing the nodal analysis. Simple. Now, if I am considering the nodal analysis, then okay, I have to erase this. Okay, so what is your incoming current? That is your 2 ampere. Okay, and all the currents are here. Outgoing current? Correct. So here it will be V by 10 plus V by 5 plus V by 1, or I can write it V. So I can say this value is 10, this will be 1, this will be 2, and this will be 10 into V. So ultimately the V value will be 20 by 13. Is this value you are getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So yes, sir. What is yes, your I1 dash? When you are choosing this value, what is your current flowing through that 1 ohm? That will be 20 by 13 ampere. Yes or no? Because I1 dash is what? V by 1, na? That is V by 1 ohm. Correct. So what is V? That means I1 dash is equals to V?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Any query?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now we are going to choose this 10 volt. Now, in case of the 10 volt, look its polarity. Okay, always. Now, current source, it will be open circuited, right? So now the current source will be open circuited. Okay. This is your 10. And look at its polarity. It is minus, this one is plus. Okay. Now, this is your 5. This is your 1. Okay. This is your 5. This is your 1 ohm. This one is your 10 ohm. And this one is your 10 volt. Okay. And look, its polarity is just opposite. Correct. So the current direction will be from which direction?
Positive to negative.
That means B to A. I am again telling you, from B to
negative
A.
Direction.
Exactly. That will be from in negative direction. That means from B to A. Here, when I am considering 2 ampere source, what is the current direction? Look. It is from A to B, correct? It is from A to B. But as the polarity of the voltage source is opposite here, so our current direction will be from
B to A.
B to A. Right. So now do the problem. Here, 5 and 1 are in parallel. So either you can do the nodal analysis or you can do your normal process. That means 5 and 1 are parallel. So if you do the parallel calculation, it will generate the 6 by 5 ohm. Okay. No, sorry, 5 by 6 ohm. 5 by 6, yes. So this will be 10. It is minus plus. This is your 5/6. So what is your current that will flow from the source? That is 10 divided by 10 plus 5/6. Okay, so that will give you 60 divided by 65. Okay, or you can say this is 12/13. Is that correct? Check everyone. Is this value you are getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the current that will flow from the source. And now, from the source, how much current is flowing? 12/13. And now it will divide between 5 and 1. Now, use the current divider rule here. Okay, now I am doing here the current divider I1". Current will flow. Okay, I1". So what will be your current magnitude?
I.
Yes. Five. What will be in numerator? 5. Exactly. Divided by 6. Okay. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the direction? From B to A. Right? So cancel it. It will be 10/13 ampere. Okay, and from B to A. Right. Now, what is the total current here? I1. This value will be I1 minus I1". Why minus? Because of this opposite direction. Clear? Okay, so now do the subtraction. 20 by 13 minus 10 by 13. So ultimately you are getting what? 10/13. So this is the superposition process. Okay, clear to everyone? And now look, don't forget to mention the direction. This direction is from A to B. Exactly. Okay. So, if you know the theoretical part, you can do the problems very easily. It will take hardly 2 minutes or 2.5 minutes. Right. Okay. Now, everyone take the snapshot of this numerical. Okay, just a minute. I am giving another numerical for you to try this. Okay, actually there are several kinds of numerical using the dependent source, independent source, all are independent sources, combination of several types of sources. Okay, so I will show you what kinds of problems are there. Now, everyone draw this circuit in your copy. This is your today's word. Okay, try this. Wait. Is from. Okay, so from the next day onward, the module 2 will start. Okay, that is your AC circuit analysis. Whatever we learned from this chapter, that is based on the DC sources. Okay, now next we are going to learn the AC circuit analysis, right? Now, this is your 2 ampere. This is your 6 ohm. This is your 5 ohm. This value is 2 ampere and this value is 2 ohm. This resistance already written. This resistance is 5 ohm and this resistance is 10 volt. Okay, so you have to find out how much current is flowing through this 6 ohm. Okay, how much current is flowing? So look here, across the these points, no names are given. So it's your work to name it. Okay, so that you can understand clearly about the current direction, right? So name that A, B. It is not given in the numerical. So it's your work to give their name. Either X, Y or A, B, whatever you like. C, D, X, Y, Y, Z, U, B, anything. Okay, so your work is to find out the current value of I6 using the superposition theorem. Okay, using the superposition theorem. Clear? So this is your today's work. So two numericals I am giving you today, right? So try this at home. Clear? Any query?
No, sir.
Okay, so now all of you give your attendances in the chat box and I am stopping the screen. Yes, done. So all of you give your attendances in the chat box. See, don't give your attendance before I said, okay, I will not accept that kind of attendance. So from next day onwards, some of you already gave your attendances from 10:44, 10:45. Don't do that. Okay. From next day onwards, give your attendance because I am giving you sufficient time for attendance. And why are you taking that much tension for attendance? Try to learn. I will manage the attendance. Okay. Don't be afraid of the attendance. Try to learn what I am showing you. Okay. Because if you gave all the attendances every day, you have 100% attendance, but you didn't learn anything, then you will get supplied in that subject. So that's not good at all for your career. Okay, so try to understand what I am saying. Don't pay attention about the attendance. I will give you sufficient time to give your attendances. Okay, so all of you give your attendance. If given, you may leave the meeting. Your class is already over. Okay, thank you everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
thank you sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.